Hi Marshies, it's me Sis, and today we're going to make a really cool looking Harley Quinn emblem. I think this is one of my favorite emblems, it just turned out pretty well. so it's going to be pretty darn difficult, so you're going to have to try to follow along the best you can. I'll try to help you out as much as I can with the grid lines and the placement of each shape. Okay, so we're going to start with the background actually, so we just need a few white shapes. It's just going to be three shapes, nothing, no biggie. You could do this. All right, let's start with, where is it? This shape right here. We're going to place it in the bottom right area over here. Enlarge it just a bit. You don't have to skew it. Actually, maybe just a little bit. Skew it just a little bit. There you go. And the bottom left corner is going to meet the bottom left corner of one of the squares here in the grid. So that seems just about right there. All right, the next shape is going to be any shape with a flat side to it, so like this one. We're gonna enlarge it, and we're just gonna, this is gonna basically be her ear. I have to angle it a little bit. And that looks just about right. Alright, and just one more shape for the background, and then we'll get on to creating her face. So here's the final shape. This little pointy curvy thingy. This will be like her jawline. So the point of it is just barely going past the middle grid line. The vertical one. And that's it. There's barely any skewing. There's only skewing for this shape, and it wasn't too bad. Okay, so now we're going to get onto the face. We're going to start with the eyeball. I feel like that's a good starting point for any emblem. So we're going to select a circle. Move it up here to the top. So it's going to be about that size. Try to match it with the grid line. It seems to almost go halfway, like the outer rim of the circle almost goes halfway on each square in the area, but it's moved over to the right just a bit. Okay, and we're gonna pick like this weird turquoise color. Let's go with this one for now. Might have to go a little bit lighter, but we'll see. Copy that one, and we're gonna make the pupil right away. Pretty small, nothing difficult. And then we're gonna make the iris, like more details to the iris. So we're gonna pick this bullet emblem. You have to kill every player on an enemy team at least once, minimum of 4 players. Try to unlock that if you do not have it. Otherwise this emblem might be a little bit weird. Okay, so we're gonna toggle the outline. So it's just the outline of the bullets. And we're going to make it a shade lighter than the shade we used before. Let's go lighter. Let's make this one lighter too. There we go. And we're going to move this one behind the pupil. So now we have the eyeball down. The iris at least. And now we're going to get the rest of the eye here. We're gonna use an oval shape. So just squash the circle. And we're gonna change it to a different color that's on the color palette that we have here. All right, so we're gonna start off with this peach color so it's easier for us to make the color ourselves. Toggle color mixer, and It's gonna be 215 red, 200 green, and 175 blue. All right, and that's the color. She doesn't have a pure white eyeball. Okay, and we're gonna move it behind the iris that we made. We're gonna tilt it just a bit, and we're gonna move it slightly left. That seems about right. Might make it just a tiny bit smaller than the iris itself. Like so. All right, next we're gonna give her makeup around her eye. And to do that, we'll start off with this weird shape right here. Gonna turn it black. All right, so there isn't much skewing yet. We might have to go back to fix it, but it seems fine right now. So you don't have to skew it yet. And now we're gonna get this emblem right here, the thumbs up. We're gonna skew it down and we're gonna put it over here to the corner of her eye and turn it black. All right, next we'll add one more piece to the makeup and it's gonna be this weird curvy pointy shape again. We flip it, turn it black, and just make it so the curved part of it kind of touches the center vertical line of the grid. And you have her eye is basically done. So we're gonna add hair and it's gonna kind of give the eye a different shape. And that shape is going to look a little bit more natural than what we have already, so we'll get to that. Let's do that right now, actually. So copy the curvy thingy, because that's the shape that we'll be using for the hair. We're going to enlarge it here. You could skew it a little bit if you want. It's not really necessary. All right, so the point of this hairline, of this hair, I guess, is gonna touch the center horizontal line of the grid. Like so. And now we're gonna add another hair to the left, or group of hairs, I don't know. And this one's gonna be red. All right, so the point of this hair is basically gonna touch a corner of one of the squares. All right, and the final hair is gonna be from this shape right here. We're gonna play around with this a little bit, kind of skew it. Let's flip it. This one's a little bit more difficult when it comes to placement. So let's try to figure out how this goes. Turn it black, of course. Let's make it fairly thick at the top. And this is going to extend out into the white space of the background. All right, and looking at the eye, there's a small amount of the whitish part to the right of it. So, like, don't go too far to the right. Try to get, like, that little space right there to make it look right. All right, that placement seems fine. We're gonna add more hair. So we're gonna finish up the hair and then we're gonna do the face. So let's see here. We're gonna need a unicorn for like the hair above her ears, I guess. All right, so we flip the unicorn, turn it upside down. We're gonna enlarge it here. It's gonna touch the corner. Like if you look at the horn, it's gonna like poke the corner of the outline. We're gonna turn it black. Well, actually I'll make it a different color just for you guys, but it will be black eventually. I'll make it red for you guys so it's more visible. And we're gonna skew it a lot. So I'm basically just skewing it upwards vertically. And we're going to get a pretty wide angle from like the snout or the nose of the unicorn to the tip of the unicorn horn. And we're gonna form an interesting little shape between the hairline, like the previous hair that we did, and the unicorn itself. All right, that seems about right. So we're gonna turn it black. And that's finishing off the hair that's closest to her face. And now we're gonna apply her like side ponytail. Again, that'll be using the unicorn. Alright, so for the placement of the ponytail, we used the ear and the mane of the unicorn for like the placement. The ear basically goes to the top right of the entire emblem and it kind of curves off. Alright, so at the bottom we have a weird space going on here, so we're gonna have to fix that really quick. We're just gonna use this shape right here and we're gonna make it a little bit bigger to block off that bottom spot. Like so. Easy fix. Alright, so next we're gonna do her mouth and her nose. These are pretty simple. We'll start with her nose. And we're gonna use this shape for like the corner of her nose. We're gonna skew it to about that much. And we're gonna place it right about there. And we're gonna turn it black. And now for the nostril, we're gonna choose this horn-like shape. We're gonna skew it down and we're gonna rotate it. And again, just turn it black. Okay, next we're going to start with her mouth. And to do that, we're going to use this odd shape, if I could find it. This shape right here. Going to rotate it a little bit. And the top part of the mouth is going to be a little bit more horizontal than the bottom part. Like the angle is a little bit smaller than the bottom lip. And the bottom lip is kind of going to go off the emblem. Okay. Like so. And we're going to turn it black. And then we're going to add like this corner to her lips here with this shape. So we're gonna flatten this one a little bit. We're going to flip it and then rotate it. Might have to play around with the placement with it later on because this shape actually affects how her teeth look like. But we'll get to that later. So turn it black and that's set. Okay, so now the teeth. For the teeth, we're just going to use an oval. Make sure that the top lip is just thinner than the bottom lip, and we're going to tuck it behind that corner lip layer. So it gives like a little bit of an angle to the right side of it. Okay, and this is going to be a really light shade of gray, the second shade below white, or above white. And for an indication of her teeth, we're going to select a dolphin. we're going to skew it just a bit and rotate it upside down. Turn it black. And just place it right about there. And now for her lipstick, we're going to use a unicorn. And we're going to turn it red and tuck it behind the teeth layer. And we're almost done. The hardest part is coming up though. The shading is kind of difficult. You have to get it just right. Otherwise her face could look off. Okay, we're going to do one more thing, and that's just fixing up her ear. Again, a unicorn. we're going to skew it just slightly downwards and rotate it. Turn it black. Like so. And now we're going to move it down below the background layer so we don't see the rest of the unicorn. Okay, now we're going to get onto the face. We're going to select any shape, and we're just going to block in the entire thing with a solid color, and it's just going to be this really light gray. Okay, next we're going to do the shading, and for that we're going to use this shape right here, the three arrow shape. We're going to select the outline form of it and skew it downwards and then enlarge it. You're going to have to play around with the skewing once it's enlarged. We're going to turn it this bluish color, and we're going to put it all the way down behind the background layers. Alright, so you can see that this gradient isn't completely flat on one side. There's like a few weird bumps going on. So we're going to use those bumps to our advantage, and we're going to try to give her like a cheekbone from that shading. So again, you're gonna have to play around with it until it's just right. All right, so that seems like a really good angle for her cheek. So I'm gonna actually just show you guys what the shape looks like, and then you could try to get it to this skew, I guess. It seems like it's very close to the original shape, just slightly thinner, and we're just gonna make it larger and put it in the right spot. Okay, now we're gonna turn the opacity to about 40%. Let's go a little bit higher, let's go to 60. Okay, now we're gonna copy that shape again because we're gonna need it for her nose shadow. This one's gonna be skewed a little bit more. And it's going to be pointing downward. All right, so you basically point to her nose, I guess. It's kind of difficult to explain. The right side of the shading kind of matches up just past the corner of the side of her nose. And again, we're going to bring that below the hair and eye layers. It's right about there, second layer. And we're going to turn down the opacity to, I think this one should be 30%, 40%. I'm going to go to 35, right in between. Okay, next we're going to give her a highlight on her forehead, so just copy that layer. Bring it to the top, turn it white. And this one we're going to flatten a little bit, make it thicker, I guess. And bring it up to the forehead area of the face. To right about there, and we're going to bring it back down. And we're going to bring the opacity up a little bit. Seems to work pretty well, so I'll keep it there. Okay, next we're going to have a shadow under her nose. So again, just copy the same shape to make it easier. Paste it. And again, it'll be that dark blue shape, color. And basically, half of the curve of this shade is going to kind of go along with the curve of her nostril. And we're just going to tone it down a little bit with the opacity. Seems to look nice, so we'll keep it at that. All right. Okay, next we're going to add a shadow below her bottom lip. Again, using the same shape. It's going to be still pretty thin, and we're going to just place it right about there. And again, just bring it down to the bottom. Layer 2 or 3. I'm going to turn that opacity to about 25%. All right, next we kind of missed a step here. We're just going to outline her jaw to give it a dark outline so you could see it a little bit better. And for that, we'll just use this shape right here. Turn it black, bring it to one of the bottom layers here. Make sure it goes above the shading. It's gonna go right below the background layers, basically. I'm gonna skew it just a bit to match the curve of her jaw. Okay, so that looks about right. We just have a few more layers, so we're gonna add the shadow, like the shading of her hair. And we're gonna use a dolphin for that. So basically just use the regular dolphin shape and then skew it vertically. And just enlarge it. And then bring it below the hair level. So right about there, turn it black. And we're going to turn the opacity down. Okay, so we're going to leave it at 15%. That looks like a nice shadow opacity. And then we're going to add one final touch. And that's the highlight of the eye. So for that, we're going to use this shape right here. This is the easiest placement of this entire emblem. So basically make the point go to the center of the pupil and turn the opacity down to about 25%. Actually, let's go 50%. It looks nice. Okay, and that's it. If there's anything off, then just go back and edit it. Hopefully you guys found this tutorial useful. We're gonna save it and see how it looks. And there it is on your character. I think it looks pretty nice. It's one of my favorite emblems that I made. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please hit the like button. It helps a lot. If you're new and like this type of video, please subscribe. Also, if you're new, there's a Q&A going on right now on my channel. If you guys are interested, ask a question on that video in the comment section, and then I'll answer all of the questions in about a week or so. If you find the voice tutorial helpful, please let me know, and I'll do more voice tutorials. If not, then I'll go back to like the music tutorials, because that was a little bit easier on me to edit. So again, just let me know what you guys think about the tutorial. I'm trying to figure out what's the most helpful to you guys. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I hope you all have an awesome day, and I'll talk to you later. Bye!